This is a demonstration of the SmartDraft create HEC-RAS data command. It can be found in the SmartDraft HEC-RAS tools or an optional module in SmartDraft suite. With this command, you can export a HEC-RAS project from a Civil 3D drawing which has section lines, an alignment, and surface. Inside AutoCAD Civil 3D, the create HEC-RAS data command requires that there is a surface, an alignment which represents the FALWAG of the reach you're going to put into HEC-RAS. These purple lines represent the top of bank conditions, and the two red lines represent the overbank conditions. These yellow lines represent the cross sections that will be cut by the command across this surface. You'll notice that they do not have to be straight. They can have multiple vertices and the program will deal with it correctly. It also does not matter if the downstream point is at the beginning of the alignment or at the end of the alignment. To start the create HEC-RAS data command, go to the HEC-RAS panel on the SmartDraft tab and select this icon. The Create HEC-RAS Data dialog will appear. The first thing you'll do is select the alignment for the reach you want to use, select the surface of where you want to cut your cross sections. The command will read the endpoint elevations from the alignment against that surface and try to determine the downstream point. Next, you can, for input for the section lines, you can either use polylines, which we will do in this example, or if you have sample lines in a sample line group, you can specify the sample line group and all the sample lines from that group will be read. Next, you determine or enter the design values. What is going to be the end value outside of the overbank? What's going to be the channel end value? Next, you're going to determine how the right and left bank values will be determined, selecting a polyline, an offset distance, or selecting alignments. Also, for the overbank condition, you'll be selecting polylines, specifying an offset distance, or specify alignments. Next, you have to specify the HEC-RAS output options. What's going to be the name of this river name inside the HEC-RAS file? What's going to be the reach name, which is going to default to the name of the alignment? Give it a title, Test HEC-RAS Data Command, and a description. Select OK. You'll be prompted to select your cross sections. You can either select them individually or select them by selecting one on a particular layer, and it will find all polylines on that particular layer. Be very careful with this choice, because if a polyline is on this layer that's outside of your reach, it'll come back and say, hey, you have to correct that before I can continue. So I'll select one of these cross sections. It will find all cross sections on that layer. There were 37 of them. It'll allow me to select other ones if they aren't on the same layer, or I can just hit enter and it will continue. Next, it'll ask me to select the left and right top of bank. And remember that the downstream point was here. So this will be left. So it's not necessarily left of the alignment, but left of the downstream. And then the right bank polyline.
Left over bank. Right over bank.
Now it's going to process those cross sections. If there are no errors, it will ask you to name the file. And here it's going to be called SmartDraft HEC-RAS Test. I'm just going to put it on the desktop. Now we'll take a quick look at that. I'm going to open up HEC-RAS here. Go browse to that file. And we can actually look. We have cross sections with the red line represents the magenta line that we selected here in the file. That concludes our demonstration of SmartDraft create HEC-RAS data. Have a great day.